You have been trying to learn everything all at once on Udemy and you run into this problem. You don't sustain your knowledge at all. And there are certain things you might be doing it wrong. And this is probably why that you're still in a tutorial hell. Everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Vicky May and I am a software engineer living in New York City. And in this channel, you are going to learn a lot of things related to tech. And especially since I am a programmer, I'm going to teach you so much more than just the tech industry. I'm going to teach you how to start learning to code, what is web development, all things JavaScript. Tip number one is to start small. What I'm trying to say is that everyone has a willpower to accomplish things, but willpower is just like the battery. It's gonna run out. Nobody can learn everything all at once. And one of the reasons why you jump from one chapter to another is because your lack of patience. And that's okay because everybody is. So one of the things that you might be doing it wrong is you don't realize that when you're learning, you actually need to learn small. And let me explain that. If I tell you today, let's just build up a website and do everything today, and you might just feel very discouraged at this point because you're just automatically thinks that, oh, that's such a huge task and I have to learn so much all at once and I have to do so much all at once, and hence it will be crazy for me to want to start anything today. This is very similar to programming. When I tell you to learn everything in that tutorial from the beginning to finish, your battery, your willpower is going to run out. What you actually need to do is to start really small. Code daily for at least 10 minutes without stressing yourself out. So coding daily is the key. You want to make sure that you do that consistently and do that every day just to trick your brain to think that, oh, I'm just gonna code for 10 minutes or 30 minutes. And the fact that you started to open your test editor, start to looking into coding it every day, you're gonna realize that you're probably gonna start coding way longer and way more often than whatever that you're thinking in your head to not to start. Tip number two is actually to learn the basics. You really need to learn about the basics before you can actually advance and learn more complicated fundamentals. You know, I've seen a lot of people who is super motivated and ambitious, and when they start learning, they just imagine that they're gonna build the entire Facebook from scratch, which is cool. And this should be something that you look forward to and set as your goal. But at the same time, I want you to understand everything starts from the first and the most important fundamental concepts. So you have to go back to understand the fact that, you know, every day for the past a week or two is not going to help you to build the entire Facebook. It takes time to accumulate all those knowledge that you learned every day. Tip number three is repetition is the key. When you practice more often, you would start to realize that you actually start understanding the concepts and actually understanding the why behind that after lots of practices. And the only way that you can perfect a skill is by practicing a lot. Tip number four, I think it's the most important tip of all of the tips. You need to learn to stop and code it out. I've seen too many beginners just clicked one chapter after the next. Instead, you need to take maybe 10 minutes of the tutorial, really watch it and really understand it. And when you think that you understand that skill, you pause and you hide a solution and actually open your text editor and code this whole thing out. Now, there's a difference between watching someone on a tutorial versus you actually coding it out on your own. Because when you're coding it out on your own, you're comprehending that knowledge and you're not just absorbing and reading and watching through the knowledge, but you're actually using, you know, some parts of your brain muscles to actually solve the problem. A lot of beginners might run into problems where when they start coding on their own, they got stuck and they don't know where to go, what's the next step. And this is very common. I've been there too. And one of the most important thing that you have to do is that once you get stuck, one of the most effective way is not to look for the solutions on your tutorial. It's actually writing down why you get stuck and look for the solutions online. Try to Google it. Try to ask your question. What are you trying to do here? Why am I getting stuck? There might be a knowledge gap between your watching the tutorial versus actually implementing the code. So what you have to do is actually going back to the tutorial, watch it again, but this time you take notes. Take notes at the point where you get stuck and trying to ask yourself, why exactly you don't understand this part and how can you do that on your own code. So then after you watch it the second time, you pause it, you'll hide your tutorials away from you, don't look at it, and go back to the problem and try to solve it again on your own. Tip number 5 is actually data structures and algorithms. And I hate to preach this because I feel like I kept talking about data structures and algorithms. There's no other way to really practice and enhance your problem solving skills without actually going through the suffering part, which is the hard part. I want you to think of a scenario where you're going to the gym. Obviously, the first day when you're going to the gym, it's really hard for you to like lift weight on the first day going to the gym. What you need to do is step by step every day at a repetition to go to the gym every day to practice your strength. One day, you're gonna be able to lift 20 pounds of weight. And that is the same idea as practicing algorithms and data structures. You are not going to see yourself solving it and solving all the other problems right away just because you practice one day. It's a accumulative of practices that helps you to improve your skills in problem solving. And that will lead you one day to solve all the other problems because you're generally just become smarter. So that is the idea behind it. I know a lot of companies ask you algorithm problems and data structure problems because it's part of the interview process. You don't have to necessarily do it for the interview. Sometimes you can look for other websites to practice data structures and algorithms. I can give you some sites down in the description below and you can check them out, and I am not sponsored by it. The key part is you gotta practice. This was my strategy, and obviously I've escaped tutorial hell, and I also get back to it as I learn more new skills and new technologies. And those are the tips that I follow through, and those are the principles that help me to escape and actually learn on my own. Make sure to check out the videos that I have over here to give you resources and ideas how exactly you can get hired as a developer after Udemy or after FreeCodeCamp. That being said, I hope this video is helpful, and I definitely wish you the best of luck in your journey. Until next time, I will talk to you soon. Bye!